Hi, my name is Narcis. Today I'm going to talk about the best methods that can be used in certain cases to recover data in pictures from a Samsung phone with a broken screen, or to backup data which can be restored on another phone. I'm using the X mark to simulate the broken screen. Warning, I want to make it clear that this video can only help in certain cases. Let's review these methods one by one. If you have a memory card, there is a good chance that your pictures and videos are already stored there. All you have to do is get out the card, put it in a card reader, connect it to a computer, and you'll gain direct access to everything stored on the card. In order to unlock the screen and then transfer the data from the phone to the computer, the following will be required: a micro USB or USB Type-C cable connected to a USB port of the computer, an adapter with a phone connection jack like micro USB or USB Type-C and a USB-A connector, or a similar OTG cable, a standard USB mouse, or a Bluetooth mouse if we can connect it to the phone, and a standard USB keyboard. There are two cases. The first one, if you didn't set up any screen lock method, simply connect the phone to the computer and there is a chance that you'll gain direct access to your data using Windows Explorer, Samsung keys or smart switch. The data recovery is straightforward on Android up to version 6. However, later versions require data access approval as you can see. In this case, access needs to have already been approved on the same computer or we can approve it ourselves as I'm going to show later. The second case, when you have set up a screen lock method, PIN code, password, pattern, or biometric, I'll first proceed to unlock the screen and then I will connect the phone to the computer for recovery. I'll break these methods down on how to unlock the screen in order to gain access to data or backup. If you have already set up a Samsung account on your phone, you are in the best position because you can do backup and you can unlock any security method by going to Find My Mobile Samsung site from another device connected to the internet. Sign in with the Samsung account and then go to backup option from the menu. Then we select the data we need. To save time, I have selected just one item and then I click on backup. In order to use this method, the broken phone must be turned on and connected to the internet via Wi-Fi or mobile data. Then I can also choose unlock phone. I need to enter the account's password again and then the phone will be unlocked. If you have a biometric configured, in most cases you can unlock the phone directly using the registered biometric like fingerprint, iris, voice, face or other means launched after this video was released. If you have set up a PIN code, we can connect the OTG connector or cable to the phone and connect a standard USB keyboard to it. Then we need to press any key twice and only the third press of a key will enter the first figure of the PIN code. It works even if the broken screen doesn't display anything. For correction, we can press backspace key for a few times and then carefully enter the PIN code, press enter and the screen will be unlocked. If you have set up a password just like before, we need to connect the USB keyboard to the phone via an OTG cable or connector, then press a key twice to prompt the password window, and then we start entering the password. If I suspect I entered the wrong password, I can press backspace several times to delete it, even if the screen doesn't work, and then carefully enter the password, press enter, and the phone will be unlocked. If you have set up a pattern screen lock, it will only work if the screen displays at least a part of the pattern so that you can draw it correctly. Using the OTG connector, we can connect a standard mouse to the phone. The first click of the mouse will enable the screen and we should see the cursor. Then I click and hold the left mouse button and move it to prompt the password to show up, which I can draw in the same way, by holding the left mouse button and moving the mouse to the desired shape, and the screen will be unlocked. After unlocking the phone using one of the shown methods, we connect it to the computer via the USB cable to backup or copy the data. At the moment, we can use Samsung keys or smart switch application for backup depending on the device that you have. I go to the preferences menu, I select what I want to save and then click OK and confirm. Select only what you need because otherwise the backup operation can last quite long. After that, I press backup. Warning, if you selected certain options for backup, the phone will display a permission window like this one. If you can't approve the access, you should only select contacts and messages which don't require access approval from the phone and the backup can be performed directly. Regarding the smart switch application, you can use 4.1 version or older because from version 4.2 onwards, it's also required installing the application on the phone, which is difficult to do when the screen is broken. We can also use Windows Explorer in order to gain access to files, pictures and videos, which can be copied directly. Phone models and applications keep changing and there may be some things that will not work. I can't cover them all, but I can show you one more solution to approve USB access to the phone, solution that is required starting with Android 6 if you haven't previously connected the phone to that computer and haven't already approved the access. This only works if you have a Bluetooth mouse and if a significant part of the screen still display even if the touch function doesn't work. I connect the USB mouse via the OTG connector and I enable Bluetooth and make the connection between the phone and the Bluetooth mouse. Then I can connect the phone to the computer via the USB cable and I can use the Bluetooth mouse to approve the USB access. The same way can be done to approve the access to the phone for the smart switch application if you want to do backup for other things besides contacts and messages. In case you don't have a Bluetooth mouse and at least a portion of the screen still display, another solution for accessing the fast pictures and videos via Windows Explorer is to enable the developer mode, which will grant access to the connection option menu. With the USB connected mouse, I go to Settings, About the Phone, Software Information, and I will double click several times on the build number until I get a message that this mode has been enabled. Then I go to Settings, Developer Options, USB Configuration, and I select PTP, and then connect the phone to the computer via the USB cable and thus gain access to the phone's memory and card using Windows Explorer. Another solution is if you set up one of the automatic backup options in your Samsung or Google accounts before the screen has broken. By default, it should be enabled. You can restore the data directly to another Samsung phone if you have the backup in Samsung Cloud, or to another Android phone if you have the backup in Google Drive, using the same Samsung or Google account from the broken phone. The first time you enter your account on the new phone, it will show up the restore option. For Samsung, you can configure the Samsung account on the new phone, then go to Settings, Cloud and Accounts, Backup and Restore, Restore Data. One more solution, if you have a desktop experience compatible phone, it's to use a DeskPad device like these two models to connect the phone to a keyboard, mouse and monitor and use this instead of the broken screen. For older phone models, Samsung SightSync application may help if you can make the connection between phone and computer. These were the best tips that can be used to recover data from a Samsung phone with a broken screen. If you like it, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Thanks for watching.